Hello and welcome to this session on web services. Today we are going to look into an overview of how web services work. So in our last session, we have seen what web services are and we have seen a real life and a practical example to understand web services. Now let us take a step back and let us go a little more deeper and understand the working of web services. So web services enable two applications to communicate with each other. So these applications can be entirely different. They can be an application which is written in Java over a Linux platform and it uses an Oracle database. And then there can be another application which is written in C++ over a Windows platform and it uses MySQL Server database. These two applications can communicate to each other over the internet with the help of web services. So web services are the services which is available over the web, but if that is true, then there should be somebody who is creating these services. And yes, there has to be someone, and we call this as a service provider. So the service provider or the server in the web services terminology is a entity that develops and implements the web services and makes it available over the internet or the web. And if there has to be a service provider, there has to be a consumer of the web services as well. So in web services terminology, we call it as a client. So the client sends a request to the server and the server or the service provider processes this request and gives back the response. So this is on a very high level how the communication happens, but to enable this communication we need two things. One is the medium and another one is the format. So you can think about it as when you are talking over the phone, phone is the medium and format is the common language that the two people can understand. So in that case, in this case it can be English, right? So in the same way, in case of web services, we need a medium over which the communication will happen, and in web services the medium is the internet, or to be more precise, it is the HTTP protocol that the web services use to communicate. And then there has to be a common format that both of the applications can understand. So the common format is XML or JSON, and they can be others as well, and we will look into it. So this is how the web services interact and work with each other. Now there are two types of web services, or I should say the web services are implemented in two types, which are the major types of web services. First one is SOAP. SOAP is an acronym for Simple Object Access Protocol, and the medium that SOAP web services uses is HTTP, and to be more precise, it is HTTP POST method. So in case of SOAP, whatever information you send, whether it is a request for creating something or deleting something or getting some information, it is always sent as an HTTP POST, and you have to send a request in an XML format. So XML is the common format for accessing SOAP web services. The second major implementation of web services is done in REST, and REST is an acronym for Representational State Transfer. Here the medium again is HTTP, but unlike SOAP, in REST we can leverage all the conventional method of HTTP. So it can use POST, GET, PUT, DELETE and so on. Again, the format that REST uses can be XML, JSON, text and others as well. So you can see REST is more flexible and less rigid than SOAP, and in the coming sessions we will look deeper into these two types of web services and we will understand the basic architecture behind SOAP and REST. So I hope web services, how they work and how the communication happens with the help of web services is clear. So let me rephrase. Web services are services available over the web, and there has to be a service provider, and then there has to be a service consumer, and they interact with each other. And to enable this interaction, there are two major things which are required. One is medium and other one is the format. So this is how web services work on a very high level. In the coming sessions, we will go a little more deeper into the working of web services. Thanks for watching.